Hello girls, good morning. How are you all? Hope all are doing fine. Okay, great. So girls, almost we have reached the last part of dilute solutions and colligative properties. So last week we have studied, I have started Van 't Hoff factor last week. Okay, so hope you have studied. Those who are not studying at start studying, because at the end of this month most probably we might have exams. Okay, so today is the last portion of this chapter. I'm so happy, finally I came to the end of the chapter. Okay, so what is the name of the topic that we are going to do today? Okay, so the name of the topic is Van 't Hoff factor for dissociation and association. Okay, so kindly put the side heading, girls. See, look at here. Here is the side heading, Van 't Hoff factor for dissociation and association. Please write down Van 't Hoff factor for dissociation and association. Underline the side heading. Okay, ready? So girls, what is this Van 't Hoff factor for dissociation and association? I tried my level best to make this topic or answer easy, because whichever textbook you look for this or you find this answer, it looks quite complicated. Okay, so you cannot understand it easily. So what I did, I made a comparative study of dissociation and association. Okay, so you also, what you do under that side heading, divide the page into two columns. So how I did on the board, left side you please write down degree of dissociation and right side degree of association. Okay, so by this time I think you must be understanding, or you must be knowing the difference between dissociation and association. Okay, so please divide the page into two columns, left side degree of dissociation and right side degree of association. So if we study like this, it will be very easy for us to study or learn for the exam. Have you written, students? Okay. So first, what is this degree of dissociation, or what is this degree of association? So degree of dissociation is nothing but the fraction of total number of particles, that is solute particles, which undergo dissociation is called as degree of dissociation. What is it, students? The fraction of total number of solute particles which undergo dissociation. Okay, so the fraction is called as degree of dissociation. Understood? Then what is degree of association? The fraction of total number of solute particles undergoing association. A small change in the word. Here it is dissociation, there it is association, which is called as, what do we call it? It is called as degree of association. So what you do, students? Write the definition on left side, then write the definition on right side. Okay, carefully write down. Again, once again, I'm reading for you. The fraction of total number of solute particles undergoing dissociation is called as degree of dissociation. The fraction of total number of solute particles undergoing association is called as degree of association. Okay, how do we show in the form of an equation? So under dissociation, AB dissociates into two ions, A plus plus B minus. Okay, so dissociation, splitting into ions. Association, two molecules associating into one molecule. So how will you write that one? Under association, N. N is a number of molecules. So, N number of A after association forming AN. Okay? Try to understand the difference between dissociation and association. Write on the equation, girls, under the definition. Left side, AB gives A plus plus B minus. Right side, N, small n girls, NA gives AN. There the molecules are getting associated. Written? Okay, let's move on. So look here, girls, after the definition and after writing the equation form, we can derive 3 points from the definition and the equation. Okay, so left side and right side. So what are the points on left side and right side? So write down, put small letter 1, let the number of particles before dissociation. Girls, students, let us assume that the number of solute particles before undergoing dissociation. Okay, that means the reaction has not started yet. So before dissociation, let us assume that the number of solute particles as 1. Okay, so what is this 1, ma'am? You can ask me, but this will be easy for us to calculate Van 't Hoff factor for dissociation and association. This is the simple way of determining Van 't Hoff factor. Okay, so let us assume it to be 1. Similarly, on right side, write down the first point. Let the number of particles before undergoing association also is equal to 1. It is an assumption, girl, students. Okay, so here it is 1. There also it is 1. Let the number of particles before association is 1. Written? Okay. Next, second point, carefully observe. Let the number of particles which are dissociated, let it be alpha. Okay, let us assume it to be alpha number of particles that are being dissociated. Okay, now the reaction has started. Number of particles dissociated, let it be alpha. Next, similarly, right side, let the number of particles associated also assume it to be alpha. Okay, written. Next, third point, let the number of particles undissociated, which are left undissociated, that means they did not undergo dissociation. Okay, understood this point? Before dissociation, 1 mark. How many particles dissociated? Alpha. And how many particles left undissociated? That means they are not dissociated. That will be 1 minus alpha. Simple example to understand. Suppose I gave you 100 apples. Number of apples you ate? 80 apples. So how many apples are remaining which are not being consumed? 100 minus 80. Similarly, here also, let the number of particles undissociated will be, here I have not written. What is the answer? It is 1 minus alpha. Write down here, students, 1 minus alpha. Okay, same is the case with association. Let the number of particles unassociated, here also same, 1 minus alpha. Okay, then when both are same, what is the difference between these two, ma'am? You can ask me. Here comes the question. Okay, so let the number of particles dissociated is equal to alpha. Suppose NaCl is there, ma. NaCl dissociates into how many ions? 2 ions. Okay, suppose there are 100 NaCl molecules, 80 NaCl molecules dissociated. 80 NaCl dissociated into How many? 80 Na plus ions, 80 Cl minus ions. So total number of particles, how many? 80 into 2 is equal to 160, right? So the number should be multiplied. Suppose the same example, I gave some few apples. You can cut the apple into 3 parts or 4 parts or 2 parts depending upon the number of people in the family. Okay, so one can be cut into 2 parts, one can be cut into 3 parts. So the number of portions we are dividing the apple into gives us the total number of pieces. Okay, so here suppose see, look here, 1, number of particles dissociated, alpha. So we should not leave this alpha as alpha. So here the number is being multiplied, the number increases after dissociation. That's what I have explained in the last class. Now also I am telling you, if there are 100 molecules, among 100, out of 100, if 60 are dissociated, 60 might dissociate into 2 ions or 60 might dissociate into 3 ions. Suppose if it is BaCl2, it dissociates into 3 ions. Okay, so here the number is multiplied. So I write here, the number of particles dissociated should be N alpha. Okay, we know that if the solute undergoes dissociation, number of particles increases. So when will the number of particles increase? When it is being multiplied by N. Clear? Now, what should be written on right hand side? Let the number of particles associated alpha. Suppose same, 100 molecules, 80 molecules associated. Okay, so 80 molecules associated, there might be a possibility of 2 molecules can associate. So among out of 80, if 2 molecules associate, what do we get? We get only 40 molecules. Okay, 80 by 2. Suppose if each molecule divides, 3 molecules associate, then 80 by 3. If 4 molecules associate, 80 by 4. So what should be done here? Should I write N alpha? No, it is not being multiplied. So if a particle, solute undergoes association, number of particles decreases. First, understand this point. If a solute undergoes dissociation, the number of particles increases. So on multiplication, the number increases. If the solute undergoes association, the number of particles decreases. Okay? Suppose 100, 80 particles are being associated. 80 particles, 2 are becoming 1. 2 becoming 1. 80 by 2 is equal to 40. The number is being decreased. So what should be written here? Alpha divided by N. Very good. Write down. So let the number of particles associated is equal to alpha by N. So understood? If these 3 points, if you are clear, then we can do the calculation or determination of Rankine factor I. Carefully write down all these 3 points. Check once. Determination of Van't Hoff factor. Do you remember? Van't Hoff factor is denoted by which letter? I. Okay? So write down. If you go back and check last week's class or notes, whatever. So we will find the formula for I. There we have seen how I can be calculated. So how did we calculate, students? I is equal to observed colligative property by normal colligative property. Okay, so in terms of colligative property, it is written as I is equal to observed. See, I have written it shortly. Observed colligative property by normal colligative property. So while writing, you can write like this, but in exam, don't write I is equal to OBSCP by normal CP. Okay, right. Now, so what is this observed colligative property? We have written 3 points na before this. Okay, so ma'am, you can ask how to know observed colligative property and normal colligative property. So observed colligative property means after dissociation. Okay, so normal colligative property means before dissociation. So look here, observed colligative property. So second and third points we will club together. Okay, so 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. What is 1 minus alpha? Number of particles which are left undissociated. And n alpha, number of particles being dissociated. So those two, if we add, if we club them together, that will give the observed colligative property value. Then what is normal colligative property? That is before dissociation. So we assume the number of solute particles before dissociation, it as 1. So I have written, carefully write ma, I is equal to 1 minus alpha plus n alpha by 1. Okay, divided by 1 means the same value will get, I is equal to 1 minus alpha, 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. Okay, next I is equal to 1 minus. Look here, there is alpha here, there is alpha here. So from these two portions, what can we do? We can take alpha common out, and hence I is equal to 1 minus alpha brackets. So 1, see this is minus into minus. If we remove the brackets, it is plus here. So here we will write 1 minus n. Okay. So after taking alpha common out, fine, understood this this step here? I is equal to 1 minus alpha, I have taken common out. What remains inside the brackets? 1 minus n. If you remove the brackets, you should get the same. Then only whatever you are writing here will be correct. Clear? Next. So what did I do next step? This 1, I moved it to left side. So when it comes to left side, what happens? I minus 1 plus 1 becomes minus 1. So I minus 1 is equal to what remains, students? Minus minus alpha, alpha 1 minus and 1 minus. Understood this step? Right. Next, I minus 1 is equal to, I minus 1 is equal to, I can remove this negative sign. Okay. So plus alpha. What happened in the brackets? Just a reverse. 1 minus n, if I write it as n minus 1, then it becomes positive. Okay. So therefore, I minus 1 is equal to alpha into n minus 1. Okay. So here, therefore, write down last step. I mean, after that, therefore, students, look here, I minus 1 is equal to alpha into n minus. From this we can write alpha is equal to, here alpha is nothing but degree of dissociation. Okay, so number of particles being dissociated. So alpha is equal to, what will you write, students? From this step, alpha is equal to I minus 1 by n minus 1. Okay, so this is the formula for degree of dissociation. Alpha is equal to I minus 1 by n minus 1. For example, below write down, students, after this, suppose if n is equal to 2. Alpha will be equal to I minus 1 by 2 minus 1. Therefore, alpha will be equal to how much? I minus 1 by 2 minus 1 is 1. I minus 1. Therefore, I value will be equal to alpha plus 1. Okay. So, from this, just why did I give this example? From this, you can understand that the value of I, when it undergoes dissociation, value of I will be greater than 1. value of y will I will be greater than 1. I need not give this example also. From this itself you can understand I will be greater. Why? Because I minus 1. It is not 1 minus I. Okay? Understood, students? So, when the solute undergoes dissociation, I value will be greater than 1. Okay? Understood left hand side portion? Shall we move on to right hand side portion? Ready? So, ready for degree of association? Write down. I is equal to observed colligative property by normal colligative property. So, what do we write under observed colligative property and normal colligative property? As you all know, normal colligative property is 1. Why? Because let the number of particles before association, we assumed it to be 1. Okay, so normal colligative property is 1. Then what is observed colligative property? Same, 1 minus alpha plus, here comes alpha by n. Let the number of particles associated, we assumed it to be alpha by n. Okay, so when you club 1 minus alpha and alpha by n, we get observed colligative property when the solute undergoes association. Hope you are following, students. Right? Okay. So anyway, by 1, no value, the same value. I is equal to 1 minus alpha plus alpha by n. Similarly, as we have done left hand side, I is equal to 1 minus alpha. You can take, look here, here alpha is there, here alpha is there. We can take alpha common out. So take alpha and inside the brackets you can write here what remains 1. Again, minus 1 by n. 1 minus 1 by n. Understood?
Yeah.
Then what's the next step? See, look here. I am bringing left hand side we have done. Here, what we are doing? We are bringing this portion to left hand side. Okay? So, I, when this minus comes to left hand side, plus alpha, alpha, 1 minus 1 by n, 1 minus 1 by n is equal to what remains? 1. Clear? Okay. Now, therefore, see, look here. Alpha into 1 minus 1 by n is equal to, if we bring this I to right hand side, it will be 1 minus I. Okay? So, now, what is alpha? That is degree of association. What from this step, how will you write alpha, students? Calculation of alpha. When the solute undergoes association, write down. Alpha is equal to 1 minus I by 1 minus 1 by n. Alpha is equal to 1 minus I by 1 minus 1 by n. Put it in a box. This is the formula which we use for degree of association. When a solute undergoes association, look here, this is 1 minus I. Therefore, I value will be less than 1 when solute undergoes association. Any one of you, you might get a doubt. Why don't we proceed like degree of dissociation? Kindly try like that and tell me what is the reason we have proceeded in this way, not like we have done under degree of dissociation. You will easily understand if you proceed like this, how we proceeded under degree of dissociation, what happens. Okay, so therefore we should proceed like this. There, what did we do? We have brought 1 to left side, but here we are bringing this portion to left side. Okay, students, clear? So this is how we determine Van't Hoff factor for dissociation and association. Okay, so finally, write one point. Write down one point, both left hand side and right hand side. Write down. One point. Students, so write down the last point. under degree of dissociation. So what is the conclusion point? Right now, if the solute undergoes dissociation, comma, number of particles increases, hence, CP value, that means colligative property values will be higher. Colligative property values will be higher, and thus observed molecular weight will be less than, yes. So what is happening? After dissociation, number of particles are being increased, colligative property values are also increasing. So what is the relationship between CP and molecular weight? Inversely proportional. So when it is becoming higher, automatically molecular weight comes down. So that's what I have mentioned here. Thus, absorbed molecular weight will be less than normal molecular weight calculated from the formula. Full stop. Okay, so this is what you should write under degree of dissociation. So the similarly we can write under degree of association. Right hand side. If the solute undergoes association, comma, number of particles decreases, comma, thus CP values, that is colligative property values also decreases, and hence observed molecular weight, number of particles decreases, CP values decreases, and hence observed molecular weight will be here less than, there it will be more than normal molecular weight calculated from the formula. Full stop. So left side, give a few examples. Example, left side students, NaCl, BaCl2, KCl, etc. Right side, acetic acid in benzene. Right side, under association. Right side students, example, acetic acid in benzene. Okay, so with this topic is completed. Till here is the answer for Van 't Hoff factor for dissociation and association. Okay, so you might be asked like this: how do you calculate Van 't Hoff factor when a solute undergoes dissociation? Then what you are supposed to write? Don't write the complete table, unnecessary waste of time. Only left hand side portion. Suppose you are asked, how do we determine Van 't Hoff factor when a solute undergoes association? Only right hand side portion. Okay, so you will never be asked together like both dissociation and association. Draw a line till here. This is the answer for this question. Now let us do few numericals based on this. Students, put the side heading numericals. Numericals. Number one. A solution containing 7.45 grams of KCl. 7.45 grams of KCl per liter. 7.45 grams of KCl means weight of the solute in 1 liter. So per liter has an osmotic pressure. OP is osmotic pressure of 4.68 atmospheres. Osmotic pressure denoted by the letter pi, 4.68 atmospheres at 300 Kelvin. This is the temperature. Full stop. Calculate its Van't Hoff factor. That means I is to be calculated. Calculate its Van't Hoff factor and degree of dissociation. Calculate its Van't Hoff factor and degree of dissociation. Written the problem. Shall we do the solution? Kindly put the side heading solution. Jot down the values given in the problem, students. What is that 7.45 grams? That is a weight of solute, which we denote it with a small letter W is equal to 7.45. Next, per liter, that is volume of the solution, 1 liter. Next, temperature is given 300 Kelvin. Osmotic pressure is given 4.68 atmospheres. Calculate Van't Hoff factor and degree of dissociation. What is the name of the solute given in the problem, students? It is KCl, potassium chloride. So, how to calculate I? Okay, see, first what we do, we will calculate molecular weight from osmotic. The colligative property mentioned in this problem is osmotic pressure. You know very well that from any colligative property we can determine molecular weight. Okay, so from these values we will calculate molecular weight from osmotic pressure. Then I will teach you how to calculate I, that is Van't Hoff factor, and degree of dissociation. Shall we move towards calculation, students? Right. So, students, from osmotic pressure, we can determine molecular weight using the formula pi is equal to WRT by MV. So, M is equal to WRT by pi into V. So, M is equal to substituting the values. So, note down the value of R also. Students, sometimes the value of R will not be provided. You should be knowing the values of R. This I have given you last year, first semester in gaseous state. Okay. So, now you write down R is equal to 0.0821 liter atmosphere, mole inverse, degree inverse here. We are using absolute temperature, hence Kelvin inverse. Okay, so M is equal to, substitute the values, 7.45 into 0.0821 into 300 divided by pi value 4.68, V value 1. So multiply the numerator. How much are you getting? I got the value as 183.4935 divided by 4.68. Okay, so if you divide these two values, you will get 39.2. Written? Okay. So, what is this, students? Molecular weight from osmotic pressure. So, write down here one sentence. Observed molecular weight. Will I write down? Therefore, observed molecular weight calculated from osmotic pressure is equal to 39.2. Below write down. Below. Normal molecular weight of the solute, normal molecular weight of the solute, brackets KCl, that is potassium chloride, calculated from the formula is equal to so potassium chloride, how will you calculate the molecular weight? 39 plus 35.5 is equal to how much? 74.5. Okay, so observed molecular weight, how much students? It is 39.2, whereas from formula normal molecular weight is 74.5. Okay, now you understood why we have calculated molecular weight from osmotic pressure and molecular weight from formula. What are we supposed to calculate? Van't Hoff factor, right? So I is equal to, so from the portion which I have taught in the beginning before these numericals, what is the formula of I? Observed CP by normal CP. But here we are having molecular weights. Okay. So in terms of molecular weights, what is the formula of I? Just the reverse of it. So I is equal to normal molecular weight by observed molecular weight. Okay, so normal molecular weight how much? 74.5. Observed molecular weight how much did we get? Right, 39.2 is equal to how much? Divide 74.5 divided by 39.2. The value that I got is 1.9. So Van 't Hoff factor, I is equal to 1.9. Okay, so we calculated Van 't Hoff factor. Then below, what is to be calculated in the numerical, girl students? Degree of dissociation. So alpha is equal to I minus 1 by N minus 1. Okay, so I, we got it as how much? 1.9 minus 1 divided by, now what is N? Any clue? No clue? What is N? Number of ions the solute is being dissociated into. KCl dissociates into K plus Cl minus. How many ions? 2 ions. Okay? So 2 minus 1. So what is the value, students? Final value. 1.9 minus 1 is 0.9. This is your degree of dissociation. Okay? So we can write it in the form of a sentence. Please write down. We can say that solute is 90% dissociated in the solution. Solute is 90% dissociated in the solution. Understood? Happy? Enjoying? Shall we do one more numerical? Ready. Second numerical, students. Freezing point of either ETH, ER was lowered, that means it is decreased by 0.6 degrees centigrade. Freezing point of either has come down to 0.6 degrees centigrade by dissolving 2 grams of phenol, weight of solute, 2 grams of phenol in 100 grams of either. Phenol is solute, either is the solvent. So 2 is small w and 100 is capital W. Full stop. Next, Kf for either. What is Kf? Cryoscopic constant. Kf for either is how much? 5.12 degrees centigrade. Full stop. Calculate molecular weight of phenol in solution. Calculate molecular weight of phenol in solution. That means observed molecular weight. And comment on your result. This is quite interesting numerical. Ready for the solution? So students, solution put the side heading. First jot down the values provided in the numerical. So first freezing point was lowered. That is the depression in freezing point denoted by delta TF. Write down delta TF is equal to 0.6 degree centigrade. Next weight of phenol, that is weight of solute, small w, 2 grams. Next capital W, 100 grams of ether, that is solvent. Next Km, 5.12 degree centigrade. Calculate molecular weight of phenol in solution. So M is equal to question mark. So what is the colligative property mentioned in this problem? Depression in freezing point. So we can calculate molecular weight from delta TF. So write down the expression for delta TF. Delta TF is equal to, look at the board, it's there. Delta TF is equal to KF into small w into 1000 divided by small m into capital W. Okay. So from that expression we can determine small m. M is equal to KF into small w into 1000 divided by delta TF into capital W. Okay, so substituting the values provided in the numerical. KF 5.12, small w 2000 by delta TF 0.6 and capital W 100. Okay, so after multiplying 5.12 into 2 into 1000, we get 10,240 divided by 0.6 into 100. 60. So when you divide 10,240 by 60, the answer that we get is 170.66. Okay, so you can calculate in your calculator and check. So write down here students below this. Therefore observed molecular weight. Therefore observed molecular weight of phenol. Therefore, observed molecular weight of phenol is equal to the value that we have we got here, 170.66. Okay, that is observed molecular weight. Below write down. Below, normal molecular weight of phenol, normal molecular weight of phenol. What is the formula of phenol? C6H5OH. Write down in the brackets. Therefore, normal molecular weight of phenol, brackets, C6H5OH, calculated from the formula. Calculated from the formula is equal to, I am not asking you how much because no time, 6 into 12, 72 plus 5 plus 16 plus 1 is equal to how much? 72 plus 5 plus 16 plus 1. It is 94. Okay. So what is the question asked in the numerical students? Calculate molecular weight of phenol in solution. And comment on your result. So calculation of molecular weight is done. What is the meaning? Comment on your result. So I made you do observed molecular weight. What is the value of observed molecular? Here it is now. This is a observed molecular weight. How much it is? 170.66. Normal molecular weight 94. Which one is greater? Observed molecular weight is greater than normal molecular weight. Look here, 170.66 greater than 94. Almost double the normal molecular weight. I don't know how many of you are busy turning the pages. How will you comment on this? Absorbed molecular weight greater than normal molecular weight means, from this we can say the solute has undergone association or dissociation. When will be the absorbed molecular weight higher than the normal molecular weight? Look at here, students. Absorbed molecular weight is higher than. That means absorbed colligative property will be less. The value of absorbed colligative property will be less. When will the absorbed colligative property value will be less? When number of particles will be less. When will be the number of particles be less? When the solute undergoes association. Okay, so that's what you should comment here. Therefore, write down here. Therefore, phenol undergoes association. Phenol undergoes association in solution, that is it exists as dimer, D-I-M-E-R. It exists as dimer. Full stop. Below, write down. 2C6H5OH gives C6H5OH twice. So, two molecules are being associated as a one. Okay, that's what how we comment on the result. Hope you enjoyed the numericals. So, with this, finally, I could complete dilute solutions and colligative properties. Now, it's your turn. My turn is done. Please start from the beginning and please study. At the end of this month, most probably, you might be having exams. Okay, so we will meet next week in the next class with a fresh new beginning, with a fresh new chapter. Okay, bye-bye.